Welcome to the New York Medicaid EHR Incentive Program Tutorial Series, Attesting to 2017 Meaningful Use in the MyPath System. This is part one of the four-part series entitled, Beginning the Attestation Process. This tutorial serves as a guide for eligible professionals, or EPs, who are participating in the New York Medicaid EHR Incentive Program and are attesting to 2017 Meaningful Use in the MyPath System. You can pause, rewind, or fast-forward this video as needed. Let's get started. Your 2017 attestation begins by logging into the MyPath system. You can access MyPath by navigating to mypath.emedny.org. This will bring you to the MyPath login screen. Select provider as your user type and enter your username and password. Verify that you accept the terms and conditions before clicking Submit. For assistance with your MyPath credentials, call 877-646-5410 and select Option 1. Clicking Submit on the login screen will bring you to the CMS Registration ID screen. Enter your CMS Registration ID and click Submit. This action will bring you to the Federal Information screen. This page is pre-populated with the information you entered in the CMS Registration and Attestation System. You'll want to verify that all provider information is accurate and up to date. If you do need to change anything, you can do so by navigating to ehrincentives.cms.gov/hitech/login.action. Once you submit your attestation, you cannot go back and make changes to this information. Any changes to this information after submission will withdraw your attestation from a submitted status, and you'll be required to reattest, so it's very important that you verify your information prior to beginning your attestation. Once you've verified that the information is accurate, click the Begin Attestation button. Clicking Begin Attestation will bring you to the EP Summary page. You'll see three entries under Description, Eligibility, Objectives, and Clinical Quality Measures. Each entry will show as incomplete until the corresponding attestation page has been completed. You must begin by completing the Eligibility section of the attestation. Begin this process by clicking the Edit button next to Eligibility. Clicking Edit will bring you to the Provider Eligibility page. You'll need to answer each question. If you're unsure how to answer a question, hover over the question mark icon to see additional information. At any point while completing this page, you can click the Save button to save the information that you've already entered. Click Yes or No on a radio button to complete the question. From the drop-down, select the payment year 2017. Click which eligibility reporting year method you plan to attest to, either previous calendar year or preceding 12 months from the date of attestation method. Enter the start and end date of your patient volume reporting period. If you choose a date that's less than 90 days or does not fall within your eligibility reporting year method, you will receive an error message. Your end date will calculate automatically. If you have questions on selecting your patient volume reporting period, view our tutorial entitled Understanding Reporting Periods or sign up for a Meaningful Use webinar. Enter your total Medicaid encounters within your patient volume reporting period and your total encounters within your patient volume reporting period. Once you've completed all of the questions in the Eligibility Information section, move to the EHR Certification Information section. Select your EHR reporting period start and end date. Your EHR reporting period needs to be a minimum consecutive 90-day time frame that takes place within 2017. Though you're only required to report on 90 days, the field will let you select up to the full calendar year. Next, indicate whether you'll be attesting to Modified Stage 2 or Stage 3. Note, Stage 3 is optional this year. It's not required until 2019. Indicate if your CQM reporting period will be different from your EHR reporting period. The CQM reporting period must be a minimum consecutive 90-day time frame that takes place within 2017. If you are selecting a different CQM reporting period, enter the start and end date. Though you're only required to report on 90 days, the field will let you select up to the full calendar year. Finally, enter your EHR certification number. Your EHR certification number may be pre-populated if you entered it within your CMS registration. The EHR certification number identifies the certified EHR technology being used to demonstrate meaningful use. We'd like to draw your attention now to the call-out boxes on this screen for more information on certified EHR technology. We recommend you pause the video for a moment and read the call-out boxes that are specific to your attestation. Once you've completed the provider eligibility page, verify that the information you entered is correct, and then hit Save to submit. A box will appear confirming the Medicaid patient volume percentage. Click OK if the information is correct. Clicking Save will bring you back to the EP summary screen. If you've successfully completed the eligibility portion, this will show as complete, and you can move on to objectives. Congratulations, you've completed the New York Medicaid EHR Incentive Program tutorial, Attesting to 2017 Meaningful Use in the MyPath System. This is part one of the four-part series entitled Beginning the Attestation Process. Please move on to Tutorial 2A, Attesting to Modified Stage 2. If you're attesting to Stage 3, you can skip Tutorial 2A and move directly to Tutorial 2B, Attesting to Stage 3.